Hey my dudes, it's Caitlin, and welcome to my first video on my second channel and on my second Animal Crossing's New Horizons Island, which is Eilish Island. I named it very last minute and thought I was going to change the island and start over for this channel, but then I got Bo and Fauna, so now I'm stuck with that. Now everyone will know that I'm a major Billie Eilish fan. Since I love Bo so much, I'm opening this video with footage of him with the start screen. And I'm so excited to get into today's video, so let's get into it. So I have two starting tips that you wanna do immediately, or if you're planning on terraforming soon, this will save you a lot of time and bells. Basically, you wanna place your houses on the beach and plant flowers on the beach. So if you're just starting and you wanna place houses on the beach, place your villager's tent on the beach, or you can move houses for 50,000 bells with Tom Nook. You don't have to have your houses on the beach, but I personally think it saves time and it saves energy and it won't get in the way of your building. I got this idea from Lex Play on YouTube. Her channel will be linked in the description and I think it's genius. I'm slowly moving all of my houses to the beach as well, and it's definitely gonna save me when I'm terraforming. Next is basically the same, but it's to plant your flowers on the beach. So I usually have flower patches and just let them do their thing. But then when it comes to terraforming, it's a pain in the butt moving them around. It's just time consuming and pretty boring. I have moved all of my flowers to the beach and it really just saves me space. It saves me time and energy. And after I terraform, when I need them, I can go get them off the beach. This works for me because my idea is to probably do the beaches last after I terraform the whole island. So this isn't going to get in my way if I'm building on the beach, because that'll probably be the last thing that I do. So next we're going to be talking about collecting supplies. This is pretty straightforward, but when you're just beginning, you might not realize how important supplies are or how much you could collect if you start immediately. So as soon as you get tools, I suggest doing these things. And even if you don't have tools, you can shake trees, so do that. So what I recommend is every single day, you should shake every single tree. This way you can collect tree branches, bells, and you can also get a furniture item or two. Once you have tools, I recommend every single day hitting every single rock so you can get iron nuggets and stones and clay. And also you will find the money rock, which will help you gain bells at the beginning of the game when you don't have many. One of the hardest things you have to do to renovate your island and get to terraforming is opening up the first nook's cranny. So to do this, you need 30 of each wood and 30 iron nuggets. The hardest thing to get is the iron nuggets. So if you run into the problem where you don't have enough iron nuggets and you don't want to wait any longer, you can actually use Nook Miles to go to Mystery Islands. I will tell you how to get Nook Miles very soon, and I will have a whole other video on how to get extra Nook Miles, like a ton. So stay tuned for that. But basically, going to Mystery Islands once you've saved up enough Nook Miles will help you get so much supplies. You can definitely reach your goal of opening the shop so much sooner, and I recommend saving all the supplies you can. So I'll talk about how to free up your storage later in this video, but what I recommend is putting all of your supplies in your storage. I know that you don't have a lot at the beginning of the game, but I will tell you how to free up your space in storage. So definitely store as much as you can. And what I do is I take one of each thing I think I'll need and place it around my simple DIY workbench, just because at the beginning of the game, you have to do so many DIYs, so much building. So it's nice to have those materials right at your fingertips, and you don't have to keep going in and out of your house, in and out of storage, filling up your pockets. You can just pick them up right outside your DIY workbench. Something that people don't realize the importance of when they begin are the balloons and the DIY recipes. As soon as you get a slingshot, hit down every single balloon. I've gotten up to 30,000 bells in a balloon before, and if you hit a lot of them, you will collect bells so quick. You can also get supplies, you can get furniture, you can get DIY recipes. It's a really cool way to advance in the game. DIY recipes are important too, because you want to expand your collection enough so once you get to terraforming, you can make decorations for your island. So one of the cool things is the message in a bottle that you get every single day on your beach. You can also find them on Mystery Islands, but this will contain a DIY recipe, and you should collect this every single day. Even if it's a day you're not going to play, you should definitely find the message in a bottle just to collect it and then be done for the day. Next, we're gonna be talking about how to collect Nook Miles. So you wanna collect these from as soon as you can and collect as many as you can Before you upgrade to Nook Miles Plus, you can unlock big accomplishments to get big sums of Nook Miles. It starts off at like 100 and can go up to over 1,000 Nook Miles. But once you upgrade to Nook Miles Plus, you have daily tasks that can get you Nook Miles. And these are really easy things. It can be as simple as popping a balloon or hitting a rock 5 times, fishing for 5 fish. It's really simple. And the thing with the daily Nook Mile collection is that as soon as you get that ding, you want to collect those Nook Mile tickets so you can see what the next task is out of the 5 tasks you get. So if you do something really simple and could get Nook Miles for it, you can do it immediately. You can redeem these Nook Miles for visiting mystery islands. You can buy things. Once you get unlocked terraforming, you're going to need a lot of Nook Miles, like over 12,000. So you want to make sure you collect these as much as you can so you can enjoy everything as soon as you unlock it, like terraforming. Next, we're going to be talking about unlocking terraforming, and in my opinion, the hardest part in doing so is getting the 3-star island rating. So to do this, you need furniture placed around your island, fencing, and flowers, and a certain number of villagers. For me, I had to get 8. So to get started on this right away, I recommend placing every single furniture item you get on your island. This doesn't mean dropping the item, this means literally placing the item. This will not only free up your little amount of storage that you do have for materials, but it will also help you get to terraforming way quicker. When I started my first island, people recommended making like really simple DIYs and placing them everywhere. But for me, it was just easier as I went, placing every single furniture item on a certain part of my island. I also recommend placing every single piece of fencing that Tom Nook gives you, which I think is 50. So I just unlocked terraforming, and to buy the permits for waterscaping and cliffscaping, it costs 12,000 Nook Miles. And as you can see, the different path permits also cost like 1,000 to 2,000 Nook Miles each. So you're gonna need a lot of Nook Miles, and that's why it's important to collect them as soon as you can from the beginning, so you have as many as possible. So for extra tips, I'm going to stress again the importance of balloons to collect things early on in the game. And also, once you find the sparkling, glittering hole on your island, you can actually dig up 1,000 bells, but you can plant 10,000 bells to get 30,000 back when the money tree grows. So you'll have one of these sparkling dots a day, and I recommend every day finding that dot, especially at the beginning of the game when you don't have a lot of bells. Planting 10,000 bells, or as much as you can, up to 10,000, and getting 30,000 back. In my experience, you can't get more than 30,000 bells, so make sure you don't plant more than 10,000. So with all of this being said, I hope that you guys enjoyed my first Animal Crossing video on this channel. I am so excited to start this channel, so thankful for all of you guys being here. And as you guys can see, I'm getting the hang of recording gameplay and trying to make these kind of videos, so please be patient with me and understand that I'm learning to do this kind of video style. And I can't wait to see you guys in the next video. Thank you guys again for watching, and I'll see you guys next week in another video. Bye guys.